Hi! Good evening, everybody! Welcome to the fifth and final weekend Devo of the Turning Point series for the month of May. For the weekend of the May 28th and 29th, episode 251. Or 250. Hang on just a second. Let me check. Okay, sorry about that quick flash. But it's episode 251. Because our Fridays was 250, so. But today is the fifth and final of the Difference Weekend series. And we're going to be talking about the Blind Man of Jericho. Our beginning passage is Luke 18:37, but we'll be reading it in the recommended reading when we read Luke 18:35-43. Our turning point is from Oswald Smith for this weekend's turning point. And our weekend reading is Job chapter 5 through chapter 12. So I hope you have read chapter 5, 6, 7, 8 yesterday, and then read 9, 10, 11, 12 today to split it up for the weekend. So, hang on just a second. Let me get my camera angle right. There, that's better. If I'm leaning back, it's better. I just had my computer screen was sitting in lopsided position, but if you're excited about this, we'll smash the like button. Comment what happened today. Did you go to church and something miraculous happened at your church service today? Or did you somebody show up, a friend, a dear church friend show up after being absent for a while? Or showed back up to church? What happened? And was it surprising? Or did you do something have a Sunday dinner? Did you go have Sunday dinner with your family for a change that you haven't done in a while? Let me know if you did that or not. But subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications. Share the video and channel with your family and friends and help me get more subscribers, please. If you can get it above the 10 mark, get 11 or more, I'll be happy. Just get it above that 10 mark, because I can't keep it at 10. I don't know what's wrong with my thing. It just won't stay at 10. It goes to 10, and the next day it's back at 9. A few days later, it's right back at 10, goes back to 9 the next day. I don't know what's going on. Maybe some of y'all can help me just by getting it back into double digits and get it to stay there. So I'd be happy if you could do that for me. But your weekend Turning Point Devo, episode 251 for the weekend of May 28th to 29th, 2022. This is the difference number 5 of the May Turning Point Weekend series. Today, on this one, we're going to be talking about the Blind Man of Jericho. Our beginning passage is Luke 18:37, which says, "So they told him that Jesus of Nazareth was passing by." And you know how in the story, the blind man and Jesus healed him. How he healed the blind man. But if you've got your Bible, I'm going to go ahead and read the recommended reading to get it out of the way since a part of it's in the beginning passage. But Luke 18:35-43. Yeah. You got your Bibles with you, turn there. Follow along with me. If you don't, then just listen. I'm not judging you for not having your Bible with you, but Luke 18:35-43. So Luke 18. Do, 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 do. 35-43. Didn't happen as he was coming near Jericho, and a certain blind man sat by the road begging. And hearing a multitude passing by, he asked what it meant. So they told him that Jesus of Nazareth was passing by. And he cried out, saying, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." Then those who went before warned him that he should be quiet. But he cried out all the same, all the more, "Son of David, have mercy on me." So Jesus stood still and commanded him to be brought to him. And when he had come near, he asked him, saying, "What do you want me to do for you?" He said, "Lord, that I may receive my sight." Then Jesus said to him, "Receive your sight. Your faith has made you well." And immediately he received his sight and followed him, glorifying God. And all the people, when they saw it, gave praise to God. I thought that was the one where he got the little bit of clay and rubbed it in the guy's eyes and had him wash his face in the river. Maybe that was another blind man I'm thinking of. But there was one where he reached down and got some clay, spat in it, moistened it up, wiped it up on the man's eyes, and had him go wash his face in the creek or the river, whatever you want to call it. And the guy was, "I can see." Maybe that's a different blind person, but Pastor Oswald Smith, who has the turning point, wrote a moving hymn about the difference Jesus made on people's lives as he passed by. So take the blind man of Jericho, for example. Smith wrote, "One sat alone beside the highway begging. His eyes were blind, the light he could not see. He clutched his rags and shivered in the shadows. Then Jesus came and made his darkness flee." Bade. I think it's supposed to be made. Made a misprint. But the story is told in Luke 18, which introduces us to a blind man along the roadside who begged for a living. He heard a commotion and asked what was happening. "Jesus of Nazareth is passing by," someone told him. The man cried out, "Son of David, have mercy on me," in verse 38. So our Lord stopped and asked the man, "What do you want me to do?" in verse 41. Then the man asked for his sight, and Jesus healed him. So what did the man do with his new eyesight? And immediately he received his sight and followed him, glorifying God, verse 43. So Jesus of Nazareth is passing by. Let him make a difference in your life. So in the life of the blind man of Jericho, Jesus made a difference by giving him his sight back. That was the difference Jesus made in his life. But Oswald Smith also says, he takes the gloom and fills the life with glory. For all is changed when Jesus comes to stay. Okay. I like that one. Coming up tomorrow, tomorrow's turning point probably won't go along with the Memorial Day theme. It's just the first two episodes that morning will. So, but bearing a blessing is what we're going to be talking about tomorrow in episode 252. Yeah, 252. For your fantastic Memorial Day Monday, May 30th, 2022. Our main passage is Isaiah 52:7. We're going to be reading Ephesians 6:15 for the recommended reading. One verse. The turning point is from William Burns. And in our Bible reading is Job 13:14. 15 and 16 tomorrow. So it's gonna be a four chapter read. Looks like that's the way it's gonna be for the next couple days. But stay tuned to that. I'll get to that sometime later tonight. Like I said, I'm gonna be in a different room. I'm gonna have a flag behind me. So stay tuned. We're gonna be Call to Remembrance 735 Part 1. 735 Part 2 is Healing for the Whole World. And then Bearing a Blessing in Tomorrow's Turning Point. So that's what's on the docket for your fantastic Memorial Day Monday. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that later tonight. But y'all see all that tomorrow. So I'm going around right now saying, hope everyone has a wonderful and blessed Memorial Day tomorrow. And with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trust in God, and He'll keep you safe. And all you say and do in 2022. And until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your Lord's Day, Sunday evening. Come back tomorrow, like I said, for a fantastic Memorial Day Monday. Remembering all those who sacrificed their lives for this great country. Memorial Day is for the ones that were taken from us in battle. All those soldiers who sacrificed their lives for this great country. We remember them tomorrow. Remember the fallen and not forgotten. They were the heroes who stood so tall. And forever they will remember. With honor and glory, they gave their all. That was a line from a song, Honor and Glory, a Christian song that came out a while back, and it has great meaning. So I'll be sure to link it into the either description or at the end of one of the videos tomorrow, because it is a good song to listen to on Memorial Day, Veterans Day, any Memorial Day type, Independence Day, anything to do with remembering the soldiers and the sacrifices they made. So, and all the sacrifices our great veterans that are still alive or are still around have made. But that's Veterans Day. Memorial Day is for the lost. For the lost souls. For the fallen soldiers. We also, Memorial Day is a remembrance day for all former soldiers and everything, of veterans and other things. But it's mainly for the fallen ones that we remember tomorrow. So, but until then, hope everyone has a great evening, and I'll see everybody tomorrow. Remember, in a different location with the flag behind me. So, but until tomorrow, goodbye.